This is an LGA 1200 AS ROC B460 Phantom Gaming 4 motherboard. I got it for my new Intel i7-10700K, as it had enough of the features I need and was affordable enough for me to choose. Back panel, shield, two SATA cables. Besides the manual and a super useful optical disc, there are some carefully packaged screws, presumably for potential M2 drives and wireless adapters. The starting point of my selection of a B460 was four DDR4 slots, as I already own a 4x8GB RAM kit. Next, it has six SATA ports, and just so happens I'm already working with six drives. Third, it has sufficient USB ports and pins. In fact, ideal for my case and front panel. In the back, we have two USB 2.0 ports and four USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports. Six USB ports in total is a good number to me. There is one HDMI port, which is nice because never in my remaining life am I going to use onboard graphics. So this prevents unnecessary clutter. If it were up to me, the audio and PS2 could be cut as well, but let's continue. There are two USB 3.2 Gen 1 headers on the motherboard. This allows to attach a total of four USB 3.2 ports on the PC case and on the front panel. Perfect for me. However, there is only 1.5 USB 2 headers, which allows connecting three USB 2 ports. Incidentally, my case has only one USB 2.0 port, so turns out that was a perfect match for my PC case. Before I put the motherboard into the case, I put in the CPU, an i7-10700K. If you care about this particular CPU, check out my short video on it. The CPU had to be in place because I wanted to install the base of a NHD15 cooler. If you're interested in supposedly the best air cooler there is, check out my full installation video. Once ready, it went into my oldish NZX Phantom case. Yes, the original one. Had to rearrange some standoffs, but it was alright. Screwed it all in, connected CPU power. Connected power. Put in RAM. Connected the audio front panel, which I now realize I'm not going to make use of in a million years. USB microphone user here. Connected USB 2.0. No wait, that's the wrong one. Connected the full/double USB 2.0 header connector. One notoriously hard to deattach USB, probably 3.0 connector. Another USB 3 connector. And while looking at the PDF of the manual on my phone, I connected power and restart button, as well as the front panel LEDs. The motherboard has some markings written on it, but I couldn't do it without the manual. Four SATA connectors from my drives go into the side of the motherboard, and two more at the bottom. Something for you to note, if you use an M2 hard drive, one of the SATA connectors will actually be disabled. Your limit of drives really is six. I was about to research M.2 prices and would probably have bought one, but knowing that I'd have to remove one of my free SSD and free HDD drives out, I'm less in a hurry. Then I installed the cooler. Check out the full video if you're interested. Connected the CPU cooler fans, put in the graphics card, an RTX 2070 Super that I'm super happy with, hooked that one up, and finally the Phantom's single USB 2.0 connector I plugged in while this computer was running because I realized that the half USB 2 pin block exists while editing this video. Instant win for me already. BIOS is kinda ugly, but not as bad as the packaging. Motherboard runs fine though, no issues yet. Let me know what system you're upgrading from and check out the videos of my other components. I will see you next time. Ciao!